Hi everyone, thanks for joining us on another edition of Ecommerce Espresso, the most e-caffeinated webinar that's shorter than your coffee break. My name is Zach Priest, I'm a marketer here at LoyaltyLion, and if this is the first time you're joining us, just a quick few things to note. We keep these episodes as quick and as insightful as possible, so we don't hold a Q&A at the end. But if you have any questions you'd like to ask us or today's guest, you can just tweet it at us at LoyaltyLionHQ with the hashtag Ecommerce Espresso, and we'll get back to you right away. Well, my locally roasted coffee that I got from just up the road in Tottenham is all ready to go. So let's jump in and meet today's guest, which is Rob Barr, who looks after the agency partnerships at ReCharge. Rob, can you tell us a bit about yourself and a bit about ReCharge?
Of course. Thanks, Zach. So for myself, my role is to look after our partnerships. So primarily that's agencies, developers, designers that we work with, but also our technology partners as well. So the likes of LoyaltyLion, that's ensuring they're up to date with what we're doing and our mutual portfolio of merchants are set up for success.
Sure. And can you tell us a little bit more about ReCharge overall and the services you guys offer?
Yeah, I mean, the slide here kind of says it all. We are awesome. Shopify Plus tech partner for recurring billing. So we power the top DNVB merchants on Shopify, particularly in the direct-to-consumer space. So anything in a consumable, box of the month, any membership type approach, we're there to power the back end of the billing on how those subscriptions are both processed and managed.
Awesome. Cool. Well, thanks so much for taking the time to chat with me and us, I suppose, today. Let's get started with the first question, which is there a better alternative to discounting that merchants can use to encourage people to subscribe?
Yeah, I think one of the kind of issues I have with our industry is this idea of subscribe and save. Obviously, it's an Amazon coined term, which does mean that a lot of merchants default to the idea that you have to discount to get a subscriber or a consumer to subscribe. Which actually, if you look at the hierarchy of why someone decides to subscribe, it is actually quite low down there. It's kind of the third reason that someone would. So we see a variety of different reasons. The primary incentive really is around the ease of use. So actually having the convenience of the product delivered to you on an ongoing basis, it's a brand that you trust, you want to make sure you receive the product, you never run out of it. That should be the primary incentive. But we're also seeing a few models being brought in, kind of the Amazon Prime style approach, whereby you give store-wide benefits to a subscriber is really, really popular right now. So for example, that can be a discount on a one-time purchase, free or expedited shipping on any purchase you make, not just on a subscription, exclusive or early access to products or content. You know, if you do have products to sell out relatively quickly, then in that case, you can prioritize your subscribers, get them through the door first, give them early access before the wider populace. Also things like, you know, discounts can be applied in a deferred manner. So it might be that your subscribers get an improved loyalty rate through points, through LoyaltyLion, for example. All these can be really good incentives. I think also right now, that idea of giving prioritized access or support to your subscribers, you know, we're seeing that across the board of the likes of, you know, Who Gives a Crap, also a lot of meal delivery food companies here in the UK.
Yeah, I think that idea of priority, making sure that you get first dibs as a subscriber on the hot new product or that product that you always want to restock on. You know, we see one of our clients, Full Lashes, does auto restock for their subscribers. So they know that they're always going to get the first stock that comes in. They get access to the hot new products as well. They get treated like that VIP without necessarily having to be given discounts all the time. So yeah, I mean, heaps of good options there outside of just discounts. Thank you. Why don't we jump into question two? Which is, what are your top three tips to stop subscribers from churning? Only three. I mean, just a small task of finding your top three.
Of course. I'd say primarily transparency and communication. So really ensuring that consumers know exactly when they'll next be charged, what that charge is for, and for how much. You know, I don't think any brand should hide and can make it opaque what a customer is subscribed to. I think really ensure that conversational commerce aspect is being driven. You know, we're entering a new era now where everyone's relying upon email, SMS, Facebook Messenger for all of that communication between brand and consumer. So really persisting that brand relationship there. And again, if it's anything around that lifetime cycle of a consumer or subscriber, ensuring that that's very transparent with them. I'd say second of all, allow flexibility. It seems counterintuitive, but really make it easy for your consumers to pause, skip, or modify the subscription. yes, there might be a short-term dip in revenue. That's far outweighed by the higher LTV you'll have from that consumer not churning out. So I'd say with that, really optimizing your subscriber portal. So when someone logs in to manage their subscription is really optimized for mobile. Also really make sure that you're flagging those retention call to actions. So ability to pause, skip, all of that is really accessible for the person. I'd also say ensuring you're actually leveraging retention tools. For example, ReCharge has a really strong retention engine whereby if someone does click and opts to cancel their subscription, you could offer them a number of questions just to find out exactly why they're canceling. But with that, dynamically give them responses that are related to that answer. So for example, if they have too much product, enable them to skip the next delivery. If they don't like the product they're receiving, allow them to swap very quickly. If it's too expensive, they're in a bit of a crunch on cash, offer discount codes directly in that call to action.
Yeah, I mean, definitely at a time like this when, with the current situation, people are kind of looking at their subscriptions, their recurring costs, all those kinds of things, and making decisions about what they should reconsider. I love that all three of your answers are all nicely tied together, that transparency of being able to say, like, hey, this is how much things are going to cost, and this is actually the value that we're delivering for you, mixes really nicely with that flexibility of saying, okay, but if you do need to change something, we understand, we're staying really close to you. And we see this with our merchants building online communities for their subscribers so that they can stay really nice and close to what their customers think and what they expect from the brand, but also what they're expecting as far as new product development or their new needs. So the brands and the merchants can start to change their offering or start to give little incentives to make sure that those customers that are starting to fade get something that surprises or delights them, a little bonus or a little sample of something new, or just a slight change up of their offer so that there's something just to re-engage them again to say, oh, okay, well, this is not something that I should forget about. This brand really does care about me. It's treating me as an individual. I should keep going with this subscription. The idea of pausing, especially what you said around letting people, either skip a month if they're overstocked or pausing, does make a lot of sense. I think there is a real sense among e-commerce managers, marketers, business owners to be like, but I need that recurring revenue every month. But if there is an opportunity for in the long term for that entire life cycle value or lifetime value, to continue, you're better off delaying that and holding on to the customer. That's great. Fantastic. Okay, let's move on to the last question here, which is some forecasts predict consumers will tighten their belts, which is what we were just saying, and reduce subscriptions during COVID-19 outbreak. What's the most important thing a merchant can do to counter this?
Yeah, I think for us, it's really seeing brands that reinforce the perceived value of what they deliver. And that's both for the consumable products that people need, the bathroom kitchen products that you'd expect to do well in an environment like we're currently in, but also non-consumables, those kind of luxury kind of craft items that you might not necessarily think to persist if you are in a bit of a credit crunch. So to say with us, the best thing you can do is ensure that the consumer really understands the value you're bringing to them. We're also entering a whole new revised retail environment. I think things like convenience and personal stock levels are becoming very paramount. People are realizing that actually being a subscriber, having things delivered to your door on a regular basis, when you can't go to the shops on your way back from the office or from work, for example, actually is becoming the core of the dorm of the day-to-day. So just, again, reinforcing the idea that, whilst you can't go out, you can't go to the shops, this stuff will arrive. You don't have to think about, oh, will I have coffee today? It'll just be there, running out of razor blades, diapers, all of those things. Just ensure the convenience factor is really put to the forefront.
Yeah, especially what you said about the non-consumables as well, the more premium exclusive products. We see a lot of the time that in these situations, people start to really rethink the things that bring them joy and bring them value. And even the consumables can start to almost move into that category of what's important, what's exclusive. People start to rethink what is really important to them. But this is a great opportunity, I think, for brands to, as we're moving into this new retail space, to be direct to consumer. But that's an opportunity to be direct with their messaging, as well and say, okay, well, we deliver you product that you find value from, but can we deliver you other value? And these are the other values or valuable exchange that we can have with you as a customer. It's a great opportunity to be really direct with that messaging. And to go back to what you said earlier around transparency, you know, to be really straightforward with the mission that your brand or as a merchant that you're trying to deliver on, and to align your values and brand values with your customer values. We see that in our research that 68% of consumers are motivated to repeat purchase with brands that share their values. So this is just an outstanding opportunity with the new direct-to-consumer change in the market, with coffee coming straight to your door, or in my case, maybe a butcher delivery today if you hear the doorbell. That's just that. That's what that is. Hopefully not in every in a couple of minutes. But as I said, it's a great opportunity for these brands to try to align their values with customer values and maybe give them give their customers opportunities to fight for the same cause. On the direct-to-consumer idea, are you seeing anything on ReCharge's side that is changing the subscription market in the current situation?
Yeah, I think it's all of it, as you can imagine. We're seeing a huge uptick in kitchen, bathroom. So meal replacement drinks, obviously toilet paper, had a huge spike. Health, you know, supplements, food, beverage, all going kind of through the roof, if you will. But also, you know, seeing a spike in some of our merchants where, again, it's that kind of product you wouldn't necessarily assume people would persist. You know, people are stuck at home. Those crafts, hobbies are, you know, more important than ever, just to make sure that people's, you know, mental health is at its pinnacle. So, I mean, across the board, just big drives there. But really, the health, fitness, you know, nutrition—that's where we're seeing the biggest uplift.
Yeah, I mean, just personally, we've been seeing with our merchants as well, this is a great opportunity to start to think about their product offerings and start to change up maybe how their products are delivered and think about changing up some of those subscription products or even adding products that weren't necessarily subscription before. As you said, things are getting delivered to our homes now that we never thought we would need to have delivered. So it's a great opportunity for brands that aren't necessarily a subscription business to start thinking about that, and obviously ReCharge would be a good company to speak to about that. That's all we have time for today. Rob, it's been an absolute pleasure chatting with you. So many great insights, and I think some really actionable things that our merchants and marketers can take straight into their businesses right now. So as always, we'll be sharing this recording on demand, so don't worry if you feel like you missed something. Once again, Rob, you've been a terrific speaker. It's been an absolute pleasure having you on. And remember, if you've got any questions for us at LoyaltyLion or ReCharge, you can just tweet at us using the hashtag Ecommerce Espresso. So thanks again, Rob, and we'll see everybody on the next one. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Zach.